here today we are going to see the concept of super mesh. Okay, super mesh is the concept if there is a current source in between the two loops. Okay, a current source in between the two loops, or else a current source which is associated with the two loops, then that kind of situation we are calling as a super mesh. Okay, so how to solve these kind of problems I will explain. Okay, we have a two loops, loop 1, this is loop 2. Okay, so this is plus, minus, plus and minus. Okay, if I am going to write a super mesh equation, okay, so primarily I have to write the direct current source equation. That is how I am going to write, means the I2, the loop current I2 which follows the current source direction, the loop current I1 which opposes the current source direction. I will repeat, the current I2, the loop current I2 which follows the current source direction, the loop current I1 which opposes the loop current source direction. So I am writing the current which follows, the current which opposes. Okay, if the both loop currents are in same direction, means I will write I2 plus I1. If both currents are opposing, means I2 minus I1. Okay, so in this case I2 is following, so that I consider as a positive. I1 is opposing, so that I am writing as a minus I1 is equals to 2 amperes. So this is my first equation. Without writing anything, we can directly write this super mesh equation. So I am calling this as a super mesh equation. Okay, then if I take this one, okay, I have to consider whole thing as a single loop. Okay, so after writing this one, I am considering this as a single loop. The current across this one is I1, the current flowing through R2 is I2. Okay, so how I am going to write loop equation? Okay, this is our loop equation. How I am going to write positive to negative? Negative, that is minus I1 R1, positive to negative, the current is I2 here. So this is minus I2 R2. Okay, positive to negative, minus V2, negative to positive, plus V1 is equals to 0. Okay, if we solve these two, we can get the values of I1 and I2. Okay, let us take a values for the same this one, same problem, and consider a values. Okay, so the value of I is 2 ampere, the value of V1 is 10 volts, R1 2 ohms, R2 3 ohms, V2 2 volts. Okay, so for this problem I am solving. Okay, because in the previous case I considered only the representation, now I am substituting values. How this will become? Okay, so what is this one? I2 minus I1 is equals to 2. So the first equation doesn't change anything, because these two are in case I2 minus I1 equals to I. Okay, there is no two ways. Okay, because in the previous case there is no current source value. Okay, we have only I. So I consider I2 minus I1 as I now. Okay, now the value of current source is 2 and less. Okay, how this equation becomes? Okay, minus I1 into R1. What is the value of R1? 2 ohms. Minus 2 I1. Next, minus I2 R2. So minus 3 I2. Next, what is the value of V2? Minus 2. What is the value of V1? Plus 10 is equals to 0. If I am arranging minus 2 I1, okay, minus 3 I2 is equals to plus 8. If I say it in that one, minus 8. This is my equation 2. Okay, in a mathematical form, I am rearranging this equation to minus I1 plus I2 is equals to 2. This is my equation 1. Okay, so by solving 1 and 2, we get I1 value as, what is the value of I1? What is the value of I1?
0.47.
0.47 amperes. Next, what is the value of I2?
2.44
amperes. Okay, so for this problem, okay, how they are going to ask the question is, find the values of currents flowing through resistance. So this is one way. So our problem will end like this. Okay. Or else find the value, find the voltage drop across the each resistance. So how you are going to do? Voltage drop across R1 is I1 into R1, that is 0.47 into 2. Okay. Next, what is the voltage drop across I2? What is the voltage drop across the resistance 3 ohm? Okay, is I2 into 3. So 2.47 into 3. By this way, we are going to solve the problems which are having the super mesh. Hope you understood, guys. Thank you.